1 second still, it's still loading.
We're live.
And with that, here we are. You know, everyone is wondering, can this be done? Is this a hoax? You know, this seems like the impossible. How can anyone sell houses virtually? It seems like a little bit crazy, and everyone's having a hard time wrapping their head around it. And yet, I am here today with two masters, two people who are out front. In mid-March, our company made a commitment not to show occupied property. We are showing vacant property very carefully. We won't go into all those things that everyone knows about safety. But I'm here with two rock star agents from Cambridge, Amy Tillotson and Myra von Turkovich, who are just power brokers in Cambridge and are leading the way. And this was an experiment. You're a pioneers in how we're doing things differently. And we have to ask first, Myra, tell me about that amazing cow behind you.
I love cows. And I saw this, I would like to say I bought it from an artist because I prefer to buy art from local artists, but that's Bessie, seen in a lot of catalogs, and I have one on Cape Cod too. It's just such a happy, big picture for our kitchen space. We love it. Everyone loves it.
There you go. I'm going to start back to, we know the world has changed. Fundamentally changed. We've got Dr. Fauci telling us we should probably never shake hands again. Mm-hmm. I was just reading that the Tour of Flanders, which is a cycling race, was a five-hour race conducted virtually, meaning they got on their bikes, on their trainers, in their garages and basements, and they powered through, and I guess they determined a winner based on how many watts they had. Now, who thought people could do a bicycle tour through the Flemish countryside virtually? And now my daughter has friends who are getting married on Zoom. The world is changing, right? So with that, let's talk about how we're changing real estate to adapt also to this market. Myra and Amy, let's start with you, Myra, in Cambridge. Both of you had two listings, but let's start with, this is our first one. You had an occupied residence.
Yes, we had a woman whom we've been working with actually. She's very methodical and did house. Did last July.
Oh, Myra, we're having some technical difficulties. Let me... I think we're going to come back to you because let's see if your internet settles in a little bit. Amy, do you want to, we'll start on the second one maybe? How is your internet, Amy?
Sure. I think it's okay. Is it okay?
I think
yes, no?
Yeah, you got a little of that slow motion stuff going on, but it's settling a little bit. Okay. So, okay. Maybe we should start with this, Amy. We were trying to do the responsible thing, and there's occupied homes. So why don't you talk a little bit about that, Amy?
Yeah, we were. You know, Linda said it earlier in a conversation that we had today, which was, it was a hard pill to swallow to hear that we were no longer going to be able to, but it was the right thing to do. We want to continue to conduct business, but we in a safe way that's going to protect our community and our clients and our families. So with the reality of notion occupied properties, we had to think of new ways to service our clients who really needed to buy and sell homes. It's not a time in history where people are doing it unless they really need to. Because they have that need, we need a way to make it happen.
Right. Myra, I think your internet is horrible and you might need to pull up a chair next to Amy. Something about your computer is very unhappy.
I'll be back.
You know what? I can go. I'll go down to where Myra is, turn her computer off, and
why don't you?
We'll meet in the living room.
Okay. All right. So meanwhile, I'll carry the conversation while you do that.
Okay.
We're looking at real estate fundamentally differently. We have people who absolutely need to buy and sell. I mean, we have one agent who's got a buyer who's in a bad domestic situation, and she's prepared to buy virtually anything that doesn't have her husband in it. We have doctors who are coming in who need to be working locally, who need to buy. They need a place to live. We have relocation clients. Our relocation division is actually busy. People have taken jobs and they need to move here. We have people who've already started working here and need to find a place to bring their family. So there are a lot of very legitimate needs in this market to buy and sell, not to mention the folks who bought a house and then still had to sell a house and financially really don't want to carry long-term two mortgages, either don't want to or really can't. So how can we figure out a smarter way to do business where people can get the job done and we weren't jeopardizing people in the process, or at least minimizing contact? There you go. And I think you're moving around better. I think this is going to be a lot better. Okay, guys. Better? It is better. Okay. Nice pivot. This is the way we work at Leading Edge. We adapt when we need to move things around. So let's start back into that Cambridge property, because this was our very first virtual only showings.
So we were very much prepared because, as I said, the woman, she's in her mid-70s and she's moving to Maine. So we were completely prepared. And then we were doing the last photography the week, I think it was that Thursday, the 19th of March. And I see right before we were going to go, I think we should do a virtual tour because you had started, you know, let's not be going into people's houses. Let's be careful. So we went with the mask, the gloves, the wipes, and the photographer and the Matterport person were in all different rooms. We were never in the same room together. They did an amazing job. And we went on the market on a Monday, which is completely opposite of what we normally do here in Cambridge. Usually it's Wednesday, followed by open houses Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And we knew we weren't going to be able to do that. So we went on the market on Monday evening. We had maybe 25 people picking it up and wanting to see it. Only about 10 were willing to look at it seriously, virtually. And lots of people calling. On Thursday, we realized we were going to have enough people to set a date for offers, which, you know, we were not expecting.
Myra, how did they see it virtually? Tell us how you manage that client expectations and how the buyers get a sense of the home.
Well, we had photography, regular photos. We had the Matterport tour. We had extensive information, but back to the Matterport tour, for anybody who's listening who doesn't know what that is, that's a three-dimensional tour. So you can actually control walking through the house, turn around, move into rooms, move out of rooms, look at the ceiling, look at the windows, zoom up really closely to the walls and the trim. I mean, you really can see at great detail what the home looks like. You can't smell it. It's not a scratch and sniff, but a great way to see a home. And you can't see in the closets, which we threw people off, and they wanted to see inside the cupboards and the refrigerator. But it really, the tour was amazing. It's a very beautiful property. It was built in the late 80s by a local developer and is very sought after. His work has a very good reputation. So set an offer date for Friday at noon. And all day Friday, people were coming in. So we didn't actually get all of our offers until Friday at around 7 p.m. Mm-hmm. And there were 5 in total. 2 were under the asking price of 1 million. 1 was at the asking price of 1 million. And 2 were $50,000 over the asking price. One had a really good tight time frame and had a building inspection already scheduled for Saturday morning. And that was one of the things that we at Leading Edge were going to allow people to do at that time, was the inspector was going to go in for a short period of time. We discussed it with our client and she was okay with that. She actually did the cleanup before and after. Neither Amy nor I went into the property when the inspection person was there. It turns out the buyers went with the inspector. We did not know that that was going to happen. And they were in the property for maybe a half an hour. And they were to tell us as soon as they were done, whether or not they wanted to go forward, because we had the four other offers that we could work with if they decided not to go forward. And fortunately, they did. And one of the great things they did to help our client is she's moving to Maine and building her own house. So her closing and move date is a bit flexible, or she can't pinpoint exactly when she's going to have to move. They're going to close on the property in May and let her live in the property for free till the end of June.
Just huge.
Yeah. Oh, and I forgot to mention, she did the most stellar cleanup and staging. We didn't do anything for the first time in a long time.
Well, and part of that was we gave her a very detailed, as we do with most of our clients, we gave them a really detailed outline of exactly what we think they need to do right to get their property ready to sell. And not all sellers are willing to do that.
We offered to do it, but
And she said, no, you know what? I've got it. And then she spent about 8 months taking care of getting everything done. So she was a really, she was an excellent seller. She needed to sell. So again, it's not for everybody virtually buying and selling, but there are going to be people in this situation who need to do it. And she was really, really willing to step up and take a chance and say, all right, I trust you guys. Let's get this done.
We just got a referral last night.
Go ahead.
Excuse me. A referral last night for someone who's coming to attend Harvard Business School. I mean, that person needs to buy a property.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
There's no question he's going to need a place to live.
Before school starts, right? Well, did you wind up FaceTiming her kind of individual areas, or nope, she was on her own? Okay. Meanwhile,
metaphor was so good. I mean, I don't know if they're all as good as this one was, but it could beautiful. See every single corner. You could see the skylights. He did an amazing job.
Yeah.
Now you had a really, made for virtual selling client in Medford.
Yes.
You told me she just rose to the occasion. People weren't going to be able to come in, but talk about that, Amy.
Well, this particular seller called me 3 days, or actually as we're waiting for the P&S to be signed on the property Myra is referring to. And she said, you know what? I know I said I wanted to wait, but now I've had to shut down my business. I really need to sell my property. I said, I got it.
We've shifted to Medford.
This is another buyer, another seller. So we had been working with her. She as well had prepared her home, but we had done the photography a month before and did not do Matterport because we were really excited about getting in there with open houses in Medford. We really knew that that would be a great way to sell. By this time, we are not, absolutely not. And shortly after this, Medford, within 5 days, the mayor said no showings in Medford. So in any case, she said, how can we do this? And I thought about it and I said, you know, we could come in and get a tour done, but how do you feel about giving people virtual tours, walking them through either on a FaceTime or a Zoom call? And she said, I would love that. This particular seller loved her unit. She'd done a lot of work to it. She loved living there. Her family lived in the area. She was really enthusiastic. So I didn't have to do a lot of convincing. She just jumped right on it.
She also has a cooking school. So she's very used to engaging with a lot of people.
Right. So she rose to the occasion. We did one practice run. She was on it.
So explain a practice run. You're on the call.
We started outside.
Sure. We started outside. She said, what do you want me to do? I said, let's go outside on Facebook and we're going to walk through and I'm going to pretend I'm the buyer and you're going to tell me about your home. So she walked out in front of the building. She brought us to the front of the building. She said, here's my unit, showed beautiful planting. So trees are starting to be in bloom. It was great. She walked us through the foyer, explained the exterior door is open, the interior door is locked, walked up right into the unit, and then said, okay, here we are. I'm going to start. I'll take you into the kitchen. She talked about all the updates she'd done on the kitchen. She showed the updates she'd done to the window treatments. She talked about the floor. She talked about how she used the space. She said, I love being in here cooking and having my family right here. We've created this breakfast nook. You know, we can be all together. She really did a beautiful job painting a picture of what it was like to live in that property. And I think, you know, just as an aside, I think that's one of the things we at times miss when we don't have a seller involved or telling that story. It's really nice to tell the story. So by the time we had buyers and buyers agents on these Facebook, we did them individual showings.
Well, hold on, let's explain. Most people don't realize that their phone, when you use FaceTime, you can put four people on at the same time. Right. It's yeah. So you were still accompanying these showings because you were with them. She was in the house. And there's also other apps for people who don't have iPhones. We have House Party, where you can put multiple people on the phone. Yep. So what you've got going on is she's home inside controlling the visuals. You're also guiding the other agent and their client, asking questions, prompting her along. But like you said, she was a star. She was a natural, but that's not always the case with
no. So I think, again, it's a very specific thing. I mean, the truth is, as we know, buying and selling is a very individual. It's a huge part of your life, right? So if you can put your buyers or sellers at ease, I have to tell you, the buyers were, there were three out of four people who saw the video. They loved the home. They loved the seller. They really wanted to go forward, but they didn't feel comfortable doing so without getting into the property. Now, Linda, this is probably a good time to explain that we have an addendum that you developed, or our leadership team developed, to solve that problem, because it's really unrealistic to expect a buyer to never see a property before they buy it.
Let's go through this, because there are things, what we identified, and here was the hang up. You can understand where the windows are. You can understand how the spaces work. You have all of the property details, but the big thing is you can't smell it. You know, people could have cats.
No scratches, animals. If on Zoom.
Right. There's no, if someone were to smoke, what's underneath the carpets? What really is the ceiling height? I know every house I've lived in, it's like, what's my view when I wake up and I lift my head off the pillow? You know, do I have leaves and trees or what I've got, right? So those things you kind of got to be inside for. And yet we're working so hard to minimize contact. So the way our addendum work is, everything is virtual. Mm-hmm. And you can explain, Amy.
So everything is virtual. If you decide you would like to make an offer on this property, we welcome you making an offer. If the seller is inclined to accept the offer, you will have 24 hours to come into the property for a half an hour period of time under the guidelines of the CDC, unaccompanied. Your agent can stay outside. It's to be, we call it a museum showing. You don't touch anything. And so whoever's there before the seller in this particular case can open up the closets and everything so that you can actually see what it's going to be in your bedroom when you wake up, and you can smell the property because you do want to know. You can listen and hear if your neighbors are stomping upstairs, whatever that is. So in this particular case, we had a very interested couple. They happened to be from out of town, but their daughter lived two blocks away, which is why they really wanted this property. They want to be near their daughter and their grandchildren. She came in the next day. She didn't touch a thing. She spent 15 minutes. She left and the offer was accepted. So,
right. You said she reported to her parents.
Correct.
Buy this unit. This is great. So just that kind of, everyone had a chance to get in. It does work. I know we were talking this morning and so many of the agents were saying, I had a hard time wrapping my head around this. And we've even had, you know, some people who, we have some photographers don't want to go in person, and what, you know, and we know that in the marketplace, there's Matt Murphy of Boston Virtual Imaging, who will send a robot in to take photos and to do the Matterport tour. But as he explained, it takes, because agents have an eye for making sure the pictures are just right. You know, it might be a homeowner who piles up, you know, the toys in a corner. It's like, that's still going to get captured, right?
I ended up doing the photography in Medford because Amy was out of town. There was a lot of stuff. I mean, like 12 blankets on a couch, on the bed that I had to tuck into the closet. I mean, there was a lot of stuff that we moved around and putting colorful pops in the different rooms and moving that huge bars, you know, with 20 bottles of liquor out of the photos. So there was a little bit of preparation for the photographs, but then
I think we're telling people our little secrets, right? But I think homeowners, Matt Murphy used the best analogy yesterday about people's clutter and the stuff around. He said, it's like people who live near a train. You know, people, when they live, they stop hearing you or you stop seeing that stuff. You know, the thing that always drove me crazy was people's dish rags over their dishwasher handle. It just ruins a kitchen photo. You know, all those things are so prevalent.
Toilet seats up are my big thing.
Right, there's all those things. But, you know, but you could, if you never got in the house, virtually go through piece by piece with a seller and say, you're going to need to move this. You're going to have, you know, they're going to have to haul it up. We had a seller in Draycott, I believe, who wound up taking his own photos. He didn't want the photographer in and he took all his own photos. We were able to doctor them up. You can do virtual staging, virtual decluttering. So there are things you can do with box brownie, et cetera, that maximizes people's space because we know people buy on the internet. And I guess the analogy I heard, which was great, is if you can find a spouse online, you can buy a house online. So that you can really think about moving this whole process forward and just being clever that it can be done. We even talked about open houses. If agents and buyers can't get into a house, not all properties, it probably doesn't lend itself to condos, but for single families, how about turning all the lights on at dusk? Because you can see inside from outside where you can't really see in the daylight. Like, how could we think about every single part of the process a little bit smarter, a little bit differently to help these clients that really need to move? Mm-hmm. So,
It's the first time, right? It's the first time we're doing this. No one's ever done it before. I think the biggest hurdle is the psychological hurdle. We can't do this. We can't do this. We can't be near each other. You know, I understand all of those because I had those initial feelings myself, but we are a creative bunch and we do want to help people and we want to keep each other safe. There's a million ways to do this. And every transaction is different. Every seller is different. Every buyer is different. But I think we can get people there and have them be safe and comfortable.
One of the other things, Linda, was the pricing of the property. The property in Cambridge came on at $1 million. In normal times, I might have put it on the market at 1.1 and sort of gotten more excitement with all the open houses and possibly pushed the price a little bit higher than 1.1. But we went on just at $1 million because actually some brokers called and said, why is it so cheap? Because they're familiar with the developer's product. I think we did the same in Medford.
They were both well-priced for sure.
Waters,
right? We don't know what's gonna happen. We don't know what that's gonna
look like. And both sellers wanted to sell. And actually when we gave each of the sellers the asking price number, they were both extremely happy, even though we were doing it in a different way.
I think there's a time to challenge the market. There's a time to put it on sharp and there's a time to, you got to move it. There's always price determines everything. And I think being strategic about your pricing now is really important. I think sellers need to know that the buyers are out there.
They are. There are people who need a place to live and it's just going to be a different world. We're going to adapt. It's terrible that we have to adapt. I don't ever want to, you know, say this is a good thing, but we're here to help and we have creative ways to do that. So,
and we're very, term phobic in this household. The whole thing with Dr. Fauci saying no more shaking hands, everyone who knows me knows that I don't like to shake hands, and that started 25 years ago.
She's in heaven now.
Well, you know, we've talked about, you know, the elbow, the fist bump, but I think I loved my daughter. Yep, we're all going to be, you know, like Japanese, you know, showing reverence for each other, I think is namaste. The way to go. Yeah, and namaste. Are you incredulous that there are still open houses being held?
Yes. Well, I don't understand how those people can put themselves, their families, or the people who actually show up at risk. But we're sitting in our living room, and I'm watching people walk by as we're talking without masks on, and, you know, two or three of them just next to each other. So some people are taking this a lot more seriously than others.
Yeah, so, no doubt about it. Well, we wanted to be socially responsible. We wanted to take good care. It really stemmed from wanting to take care of our own agents. Right. You know, as much as I'm thinking in and out of people's houses, interacting and knowing that it is the people who are asymptomatic who are spreading the disease. Sick people are home. It's the people who don't know they're sick or carrying it that are the problem. And there's always a creative solution when you're dealing with smart people, people willing to be open-minded to doing things new ways, having the right clients with the right mindset too. Not everyone's built for this.
Linda, one quick note for anybody who's watching this who doesn't understand why Myra and I are sitting so close to each other without masks on. We live in the same house. I live with my and her husband, so we're sheltering in place together, which is good. She's an amazing cook, and she cooks a lot for us.
It's a lot of fun, and we're growing a lot of plants and doing all the other things, doing a lot of reading and
working out every day. I mean, we are so blessed. Yeah. Our mother lives across the street, and we attack her with wipes when she shows up at the house, but we are blessed that we can live the way we live right now.
Yeah. And do this. And
we're having fun. Zoom meetings every morning with you guys. Blast, you know, keeping up with friends who you haven't seen or talked to in a long time. That's been really fun.
Yeah. I mean, if there is a silver lining, I think it's the moment of pause that we can all take. It's the ability to tap into more creative solutions around your life and your work. I can't tell you, shameless plug for Leading Edge, I can't tell you how wonderful it is to work with a leadership team who is so incredibly selfless and creative.
And invested in
and
us.
And invested in our company, our clients, and the work that we're doing. So we are just, couldn't be more
happier. Grateful. Yes, we're having a good time, even though we can't go anywhere.
Well, we're looking forward to
everything you and the team are doing is really, the Mary Ellen and all the other people who work for you are over the moon. They're amazing. Fabulous.
Yeah. We are lucky to have a great staff and fabulous agents. Thank you guys for being on our very first Facebook Live, let's show them what we're doing kind of PowerCast. And with that, to those who celebrated Passover, happy Passover and happy Easter to everybody. Enjoy the nice weather that's coming up this weekend. All righty.
Thanks, Linda. And if you want, if anybody wants to talk to either Amy or me, they are welcome. And we will walk them through the different things that we were able to do.
What? As the pioneers, you've already made all the initial mistakes, right? So that we can figure it all out. That's
exactly. You didn't make any mistakes. You didn't make any mistakes.
Exactly. Thanks, guys. Appreciate it. Take care. Bye-bye.
Namaste.
Bye. Namaste.